Welcome to our Alignas. This is Mom Teresa Tubal. Join me to enjoy mathematics. Are you ready to explore about remainder theorem and factor theorem? Let's go. Let us discuss first the remainder theorem. What is the remainder theorem? If the polynomial p of x is divided by x minus c, then the remainder is p of c. Let us divide 3x squared minus 4x plus 7 divided by x minus 1. We may use synthetic division or remainder theorem. So let us solve using synthetic division. X minus 1 is equal to 0, so x is equal to 1. The coefficients of 3x squared minus 4x plus 7 are 3, negative 4, and positive 7. So let us solve. Bring down 3. 3 times 1 is 3. Subtract, copy the big sign. So negative 4 plus 3, subtract, that is 1. Copy the big sign, that is negative 1. Negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. 7 minus 1, the answer is equal to 6. So the remainder is equal to 6. What if we try remainder theorem? So x minus 1 is equal to 0, or x is equal to 1. P of x is equal to 3x squared minus 4x plus 7. Let us replace the value of x by positive 1 to the given equation. So that becomes P of 1 is equal to 3, copy, replace x by 1 squared minus 4 times 1 plus 7. P of 1, 1 times 1 is 1, times 3, 3. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4, bring down 7. Let us solve. 3 plus 7 is 10, minus 4 is equal to 6. Or 3 minus 4 is negative 1 plus 7, so the P of 1 is equal to 6. So it means pwede natin gamitin synthetic division or by using remainder theorem. So let us explore more about remainder theorem. Example number 1. Determine the remainder of 3x squared minus 7x plus 2 when divided by x minus 3. So let us solve for x. So x minus 3 is equal to 0, so x is equal to positive 3. Negative 3 going to right, that is positive 3. Next, the dividend. P of x is equal to 3x squared minus 7x plus 2. So using the remainder theorem, we need to replace the value of x by 3 to the given equation. So that becomes P of 3 is equal to copy 3, replace x by 3, so that becomes 3 squared minus copy positive 7 times replace x by 3 and then copy positive 2. Next, let us solve. 3 times 3 is equal to 9 times 3 is 27 minus 7 times 3 is 21 plus 2. So the value of P of 3 is equal to 8. 27 minus 21 is equal to 6. 6 plus 2, the answer is equal to 8. Or 27 plus 2 is 29 minus 21, the answer is equal to 8. How about number 2? Given the P of x is equal to 3x cubed minus x squared plus 4x minus 1, what is the value of P of negative 2? So, meron tayong x that is equal to negative 2. So, let us replace. Replace the value of x by negative 2 to the given equation. So, that becomes P of negative 2 is equal to copy 3. Replace x by negative 2. So, that is 3 times negative 2 cubed minus replace x by negative 2 again. So, negative 2 squared copy plus 4 copy replace x by negative 2 minus 1. So let us solve. So negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2, the answer is equal to negative 8 times 3 minus negative 2 times negative 2, the answer is equal to positive 4. And then 4 times negative 2 is negative 8, copy negative 1. Next, P of negative 2 is equal to 3 times negative 8 is negative 64. Negative times positive is negative 4. Copy negative 8, copy negative 1. So it means the P of negative 2 is equal to negative 77. Negative 64 minus 4 is negative 68. Negative 68 minus 8 is negative 76. Negative 76 minus 1 is negative 77. So the P of negative 2 is negative 77. Find the value of k that will give a remainder of 12 when x to the 4th plus kx cubed minus the quantity k plus 4 times x plus 6 is divided by x plus 2. Let us get the value for the p of c. So x plus 2 is equal to 0, so x is equal to negative 2. So afterwards, let us get the dividend. So p of x is equal to x to the 4th plus kx cubed minus k the quantity k plus 4x plus 6. So the remainder is equal to 12. So it means we need to write the remainder, the p of negative 2, the remainder is 12. And then replace the value of x by negative 2 to the given equation. So that becomes negative 2 to the 4th plus, we have no value of k, so copy positive k, times negative 2, x is negative 2, raised to the 3rd power, minus copy k plus 4, replace x by negative 2 plus 6. So let us solve all the parentheses. So that becomes bring down positive 12 is equal to negative 2 to the 4th. So it means negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. So 4 times we need to multiply negative 2. So negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. Negative 8 times negative 2 is equal to 16. Plus k. Negative 2 3 times. So negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Positive 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. Next, bring down minus. Then we need to multiply the parentheses. So that becomes negative 2 times k, or k times negative 2 is negative 2k. And then positive 4 times negative 2 is negative 8 plus 6. Next, we need to multiply all the parentheses. So that becomes bring down 12 equals 16. And then negative 8 times k, or k times negative 8 is negative 8k. And then we need to distribute negative to the parentheses. Negative times negative is positive 2k. Negative times negative is positive 8. And then bring down positive 6. So let us combine. So bring down 12, and then let us combine negative 8 and 2k. So negative 8k plus 2k is negative 6k. Why? Subtract, copy the big sign. So negative 8 plus 2, subtract, copy the big sign. So that is negative 6k. Next, let us combine 16 plus 8 plus 6. 16 plus 8 is 24 plus 6. The answer is equal to 30. So let us combine like terms. So let us combine 12 and 30. So that becomes bring down 12. Change the sign of positive 30 going to right. We need to transpose. So 12 minus 30 is equal to bring down negative 6k. 12 minus 30, subtract, copy the big sign. So that becomes negative 18. Bring down negative 6k. To solve for k, we need to divide both sides by negative 6. So the value of k is equal to 3. 3 is equal to k, or k is equal to 3. Because 18 divided by 6 is 3. Negative divided by negative, the answer is positive 3. Negative 6 divided by negative 6, the answer is equal to 1. Let's do it about remainder theorem. Instruction, pause the video and try to solve on your own. Question number 1. Given the p of x is equal to x cubed minus 4x squared plus 5x minus 2, what is the value of p of negative 1? Correct. The answer is equal to negative 12. How about number 2? Find the value of m when 2x cubed minus mx squared plus 5 is divided by x minus 2 and yielded a remainder of 4. What is the answer? Correct. The answer is equal to 17 over 4. So let us discuss about factor theorem. What is factor theorem? Given a polynomial p of x, the expression x minus c is a factor of polynomial if and only the value if p of c will yield up to 0, that is p of c is equal to 0. So let us apply factor theorem. It should be the remainder must be equal to 0. Thus, x plus 3 is a factor of x cubed minus 6x plus 9. So let us solve. X plus 3 is equal to 0, so x is equal to negative 3. So the solution, as you can see, is the same with remainder theorem. But the remainder must be equal to 0. Okay, next. P of x is equal to x cubed minus 6x plus 9. We need to replace the value of x by negative 3 to the given equation. So that becomes p of negative 3 is equal to negative 3 cubed minus, bring down 6, replace x by negative 3 plus 9. So let us solve. P of negative 3 is equal to negative 3 cubed. It means negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. Negative 3 times 3 is 9. 9 times negative 3 is negative 27. And then negative 6 times negative 3 is positive 18, bring down positive 9. So let us combine. P of 3 is equal to 0 because negative 27 and then 18 plus 9 is 27. Negative 27 plus 27, the answer is equal to 0. So it means, yes, x plus 3 is a factor of x cubed minus 6x plus 9. How about number 2? Thus, x plus 2 is a factor of x to the fifth minus 4x cubed plus 5x plus 1. So let us solve. X plus 2 is equal to 0, so x is equal to negative 2. So let us replace the value of x by negative 2 to the given equation. So that becomes p of negative 2 is equal to negative 2 to the fifth power minus 4. Replace x by negative 2, so negative 2 cubed. Plus 5, replace x by negative 2, plus 1. So let us solve the parentheses. So that becomes p of negative 2 is equal to negative 2 to the fifth power. So it means we need to multiply negative 2 5 times. So negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. Negative 8 times negative 2 is 16. 16 times negative 2 is negative 32. Next. Bring down negative 4. Negative 2 cubed. It means negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. And then 5 times negative 2 is negative 10 plus 1. Multiply the parentheses so that becomes p of negative 2 is equal to copy negative 32. Negative 4 times negative 8 is positive 32. Negative 10, bring down positive 1. So let us solve. Negative 32 plus 32 is equal to 0. And then negative 10 plus 1, subtract, copy the big sign. So the p of negative 2 is negative 9. But then the remainder is not equal to 0. So it means no. So x plus 2 is not a factor of x to the fifth minus 4x cubed plus 5x plus 2. How about example number 3? Is x minus 1 is a factor of x cubed minus 4x squared plus 5x minus 2? So let us solve. X minus 1 is equal to 0, so x is equal to positive 1. Let us replace the value of x to the given equation. So that becomes p of 1 is equal to replace x by 1, 1 to the third power, bring down negative 4, replace x by 1 squared plus 5 times 1 minus 2. So p of 1, 1 cubed, so 1 times 1 is 1, times 1 is 1. Bring down negative 4. And then why we bring down negative 4? Because 1 times 1 is 1, times negative 4 is negative 4. 5 times 1 is 5, and then bring down negative 2. So let us solve. 1 minus 4 is negative 3. Negative 3 plus 5 is positive 2. Positive 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Or we may combine all positive and all negative. So 1 plus 5 is 6. Negative 4 and negative 2 add, copy the big sign, so that is negative 6. So it means 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. So the P of 1 is equal to 0, so or the remainder is equal to 0. So it means x minus 1 is a factor of x cubed minus 4x squared plus 5x minus 2. So let us apply what you have learned about factor theorem. Instruction, pause the video and try to solve on your own. Question number 1. Does x plus 5 is a factor of x cubed plus 4x squared minus 5x? Yes or no? Correct. The answer is yes, because x plus 5 is a factor of that given equation because the remainder is equal to 0. How about number 2? Does x plus 1 is a factor of x to the fifth plus 7x plus 8? What is the answer? Correct. The answer is no, because x plus 1 is not a factor of x to the fifth plus 7x plus 8. How to identify the remainder? We will get the remainder using remainder theorem or using synthetic division. How about the factor theorem? The factor theorem, the remainder must be equal to 0 to identify if the divisor is a factor of the dividend. I hope you learned something new. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.